It's the NFL on EA Sports, where division rivals will clash in the AFC North. It's the Baltimore Ravens and the Cleveland Browns, and it's coming up next.
Now, from the home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Cleveland, Ohio, EA Sports proud to welcome you to Huntington Bank Field, the home of the Browns. A good one looming in one of the tougher divisions in football. Mike Tirico, Greg Olson with you. Greg, this division, year in, year out, man, it is physical. It's tough, and it's always tight at the top. You get here one more year, and you look at everybody, and you can make a case that this could be a team that can make a playoff run.
Yeah, and especially the case, Mike, that last year, three of the four teams made the playoffs, the only exception being the Cincinnati Bengals, who went 9-8 without their star quarterback Joe Burrow down the stretch. So here you are going into this year. All four of these teams are legitimate playoff contenders, and when you look around the league, I'm not sure there's another division with a straight face that I'd be willing to say that.
Tylan Wallace now on the return. Oh, he's got room past the 30. They finally get him down, but he gets all the way up close to the 40-yard line. The Ravens led out by the reigning MVP of the National Football League, Lamar Jackson, already season 7. Greg, he's won a couple of MVPs, and he's as talented as we see in the league.
We had a couple of his games early in his career, and of course, all the way to his days back in college, his athleticism jumps off the screen. But Mike, these last couple years, his development as a true passer, his ability to operate from the pocket, that's what's really taken his game to this MVP level. And tell you what, we didn't think there was a lot more things that he could do on a football field, and it seems like every year he's proven otherwise. So they're trying to get the ball out of the hand of the quarterback. That's the best way to slow down any good pass rush, but the accuracy and the run after catch is a critical part of the play. So when this ball is not thrown out in front, what they call the front shoulder pad throw, it makes it really hard for this slant route to get completed when the ball's thrown so far behind him.
On play action, here's Jackson. And he's going to be taken down right at midfield.
Every once in a while, it just comes down to you need somebody in the huddle to just make a play, and it wasn't a whole lot fancy here. The quarterback just dumps the ball down, a quick underneath completion, and then really it's the yards after catch that did the rest, and that's what it takes. You're not always going to have the perfect play. You're not always going to dial up the perfect play against the perfect look. Sometimes players need to make plays, and that was a good one there.
Give them 12 on that one. They are on the march. Another first down.
I think they're going to have to be more creative here on the back end with the types of coverages they show this quarterback. Change the look pre-snap to post-snap. Mix in zone, mix in man. They got to make it more challenging on the quarterback going forward.
Just pushing guys away as he takes this forward for a gain of 7. Here's a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. They're going to go right back to Henry. Trying to find some place to go, but nothing developing. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 1.
This is what every defense in the league is shooting for, Mike. Negative plays. That's how you kill drives. Force teams to play from behind the sticks. Great job here, taking him down for a loss.
Here's a 3rd down and 4. It's the tight end likely in motion. 3rd and short, Jackson. Coming open, that's the tight end likely. And he will have the 1st down. The drive will continue after a pickup of 8.
Well, we'll give a little credit here defensively. Even though they allow the 1st down, we've seen defenses really struggle bringing this big tight end to the ground, and they didn't allow him to pick up a bunch of yards after contact, but he was able to get just enough to pick up the 1st down.
They'll come up here 1st and 10. From the gun, Jackson. That one pinballs around, but it is incomplete. Searching for his Pro Bowl tight end Mark Andrews that time. And that will lead to a second down.
Up until that incompletion, they've done a really nice job on this drive, Mike, picking up fresh sets of downs. And typically, throwing the ball on first down is a great way to do it. But now they find themselves in second and 10. Do you keep it in the air and try to get the first down here? Or is the idea to just make third down manageable and take your chances picking up a key third down? Number one rule of run blocking for the offensive line is you don't want to allow penetration. It just doesn't give your running back any angles to cut and find the hole. It's exactly how it played out here. They've got to do a better job holding the line of scrimmage and not getting pushed back.
On third down, Jackson. And that is incomplete.
He decides to go with the safe throw and throws it well short of the sticks. And at this level, Mike, you just can't miss layups like that.
On fourth down, on comes the seven-time Pro Bowler, Justin Tucker, for the Ravens field goal. He'll bang that one through. It's good. And the Ravens will take a 3-0 lead.
And that's a good drive right out of the gate. They're able to make some plays, move the ball down the field. I know they didn't get a touchdown, but that is a good positive result.
Three points on that opening drive. We'll see the response as the kick's away. On the return, it's Jerome Ford. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Cleveland offense set to take the field for the first time. They'll be led out by the former number one overall pick back in the 2015 draft, former Heisman winner as well, Jameis Winston.
He spent a lot of time, Mike, over these last couple days speaking to the media, and the thing that jumped out to me was just how confident he was in his team's preparation ahead of today's game. Now, only time will tell or not whether it makes a difference, but if his confidence is any indication of how they're going to perform, this could be a tough team to beat.
Now the Georgia Bulldog. Here's Nick Chubb. And this play's going nowhere. Taken down behind the line. A great way for this defense to get on the field and get started.
Well, they try to get the run game started here early on this drive, Mike, and they're just going to have to do a better job up front. There's really nowhere for this ball carrier to go. You never want to lose yards on first down, but that's exactly the case here.
Once again, it's Chubb. And a nice run there as he surges forward. A gain of 8. And sets up third down. Out of the gun, it's Winston. And the quarterback scrambling, maneuvers his way back to the line of scrimmage, but that's all he can get out of that one.
So often the best pass defense is a good pass rush, and that's exactly what we saw here. The pass rush disrupted this play from the very start. The quarterback has all of his attention on the rushers rather than his receivers downfield. All he can manage to do is get back to the original line of scrimmage.
So on fourth down, the lefty Corey Bohorquez to punt for Cleveland. And that is good coverage by the punt team as they meet him and bring him down. The Ravens offense ready to get going with their second possession. They had the field goal on the opening drive to take the early lead. See if they can improve on it here. 3-0 is our score, and it's first and 10. Off the play fake, Jackson. The pressure gets there, and down he goes back inside the 20-yard line.
It's so easy to underestimate the speed of this quarterback until you get on the field. they break down your pursuit angle so quickly because of that speed. So give credit to the defense. They understand it's a collective effort to contain this guy. And this time, defense wins and brings him down for a sack.
After the loss of three, it is second and 13. In the shotgun, here's Jackson. There's a short one caught by Andrews. And that's a good gain there. It's going to wind up just a couple of yards shy of that first down.
So the hope is when you call these underneath drag routes, you're trying to have your tight end come out the backside of the defense in space. So when you put the ball on them early, it leads to big yards after the catch. In this case, they don't get the real big play they were hoping for, but they'll definitely take it.
He's got his tight end. That's Andrews. And the defense can't come up with a stop there. Gain of seven and a first down.
One of the easiest ways to negate these really good pass rushes in the NFL, Mike, is just to simply get the ball out of the quarterback's hand as fast as possible. And sometimes it's by design, sometimes it's based on need, but really nice job there by the quarterback, getting into the hands of his receiver and then see what he can do after the catch.
A deep shot for Aguilar. That one broken up. It is incomplete. They tried the shot on first down, couldn't connect. It'll bring up second down.
He's trying to set the tone here for the rest of the game and let this defense know there is not a blade of grass on this field that you don't have to defend, because he reared back and he let that one eat. And he's got to work a little bit on his touch, a little bit on his accuracy, but I don't think he needs to work on his arm strength.
Pitch to the right side. He's got Andrews. Four catches already in this opening quarter, off to a hot start as he picks up the first down.
Not a whole lot complicated about this play, Mike. That was understanding where the holes of the defense were. Remember, in this zone coverage, you got to find green grass, get past the first down marker, be friendly to the quarterback, and then the ball has to be out on time before those zone defenders can react to the receiver. It's exactly how it played out here. You can draw up all the fancy plays you want, but when the quarterback and the receiver see it through the same set of eyes, it's virtually impossible to stop.
Give them 15 more on that one. They are on the move. It's a first down. Throwing Jackson. Brought in by the tight end, Andrews. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line.
Now, this is the epitome of a really short throw and a really nice run after catch. And listen, for a quarterback, it all counts the same. You don't always have to throw the ball downfield to generate explosive plays, and these drag routes can be very, very effective.
Now Lamar, gonna hang on to it, and he's gonna be brought down on what will be the final play in this opening quarter. So just a lone field goal in the first quarter of play. It's the Ravens out front, and we're back to Cleveland in a minute. Ball resting on the nine. First down and goal. Here's a run. Marked down at the six. Second and goal. Again, it'll be Henry. Looking for a seam, but will not find one. He'll take this down to the 4-yard line. Last drive yielded three. They'd like more. Let's see what happens on third and goal. Here's Jackson. And he's going to be stopped. He gets two down to the 2-yard line. But now it's fourth down.
You could tell that this defense was ready for this exact play call. They know that they're going to give their quarterback a chance both through the air and on the ground with his legs. They do a nice job stopping him short of the goal line to force fourth down.
This has been quite the drive. 3 points would kind of feel like a letdown. So they're going to go for it here on fourth and goal. They'll run for it with Henry. And he's not going to get there. The defense was ready for it. And they stuff him on fourth down.
Well, I'll tell you, Mike, I'm feeling pretty good about my chances of picking up this fourth down when I've got big old Derrick Henry in the backfield. So what an unbelievable job by this defense coming up with a huge fourth down stop.
The Browns offense ready to see what they can do on their second possession. They'll need to get something positive going right away here. Ball starts inside their own 1 yard line. Three tight ends in the game to start the drive. On the ground, it's Chubb to start this drive. And he'll manage to get this ahead for a pickup of 5. They'll break the huddle. It's 2nd and 5. Second down throw for Jameis. And that one knocked away. It's incomplete.
I like the idea of using the passing game to try to give your offense a little breathing room. You find yourself in the shadow of your own goalpost, Mike. Worst case scenario, you do not want to punt out of your own end zone. So I like the idea of trying to pick up some positive gains through the air, but they've got to come up with some completions and try to pick up at least one first down. Oh, you're going to put your defense in a tough spot. Well, nothing real fancy here, Mike. Not a huge pickup, but anytime on third down, you got to know where the sticks are, who's your most reliable player, and I think everybody in this booth knows exactly what position that is.
1st and 10. From the gun, Winston. We'll go right back to Njoku. He's got it again. 11 yards on the connection there. 1st down, Cleveland.
Just seems like every year, Mike, the tight end position just continues to grow within the passing game and establishes a bigger and bigger role. And listen, I know I'm biased, but if you want to have a good passing game, you better have a good tight end.
They'll run it straight ahead with Chubb. And he finds some space, tackled after a gain of 7 on 1st down. Second down and 3. Njoku, the tight end, is the one in motion. On the handoff, this is Chubb. And he'll take this to the 35, and that'll move the chains. It's a 1st down.
I think this 2nd down call, Mike, they were hoping that at worst, they had themselves set up for a 3rd down and short. But there's no need for 3rd down. He was able to get enough on 2nd, and they get a fresh set of downs.
Ball out to the 35-yard line as they come up for 1st and 10. A run up the middle with Chubb. And a good run there. Going to get him 5 yards. A 2nd down throw for Winston. He gets this one to Moore. They'll get maybe 3 out of that one, and it's going to set up 3rd down.
The receiver thought he had a nice soft spot in that zone coverage, and he settles down to give a nice target to the quarterback. But the defense had eyes on him the entire time. Secure rally tackle prevents that from turning into a big play.
They'll try and run it here, and it's Chubb. And that one shut down pretty quickly. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Nothing more.
Great job by that linebacker timing his blitz. He didn't give any indication to the offense that he was coming, and he's able to get through that hole and take the ball carrier down for a loss.
Here's Corey Bohorquez now. He's on for the second time. He'll try to get something inside the 10. And no return forthcoming. It's a touchback and will come out to the 20-yard line. The Ravens offense getting set to get back to work. They'll look to build on their 3-0 lead as this drive starts with a first and 10. It's the tight end Likely in motion. Jackson fires complete to Flowers. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up 2nd and 5. Here's Lamar. He'll keep it on the zone read. And they'll bring him down, but not until he gets to the 38-yard line. It's a pickup of 13 yards. Good for a Raven first down. 2 minutes remain in a 3-0 first half. We'll have more from Cleveland after this. So, 1st and 10 here now at the 38. To throw is Jackson. That's complete to the veteran Nelson Aguilar. And he's down inside the 40-yard line.
And now you can see they're really getting in rhythm in this 2-minute drive. Now, after that last completion, Mike, they cross midfield. Now the mindset goes to, all right, we got to come away with some points. They've got a quarterback who's in complete control, and they got to see if they can finish this thing off.
Ball rests at the 37. It's 1st and 10. Aguilar goes off in motion. Jackson now to throw on 1st down. Open man, that's Bateman downfield. And they're going to be set up in the red zone. They've got it inside the 15. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. Halftime is looming, so the athletic training staff to get a chance to look him over during the break. Down at the 12, it's 1st and 10. Bateman is the motion man. A 1st down throw for Jackson. After the catch, he gets that forward for a gain of 9.
So they have these rules for the receivers, Mike. They call them green grass rules. And the idea is if you're running across the field and you're looking at the quarterback, you're going to stay on the run. If you're not looking at the quarterback, that tells him, I'm going to sit in this soft zone. I'm going to what they call punch and pivot and stop. And that tells the quarterback to put the ball on your chest.
That one, taken in, middle of the end zone. Nelson Aguilar, touchdown Ravens. Tight spaces down there, things happen quick. Greg, a quick decision and great execution for the score.
You're exactly right, Mike. Down here this close to the goal line, everybody's clock has to speed up. Not only the quarterback processing to get the ball out of his hand, but you have to win as a receiver quickly and give the quarterback somewhere to go with the ball. It was that quickness at the line of scrimmage that led to that touchdown.
Now Justin Tucker for the point after. It's up and through. And the Ravens are out to a 10-0 lead. Still a little time. Final minute of this first half. We'll see if they can do anything with this kickoff that is coming their way. Nice job on the return. He's down close to the 35-yard line. The Browns offense gonna take over here in the final minute of this first half. And nothing doing from the offense just yet. Down 10-0 as they come up with first and 10. Throwing, Jameis. That's over the middle to his tight end, Njoku. And that keeps him ahead of schedule. That's a first down completion of 7 yards. Here's second and 3 to go. To throw, here's Winston. A quick slant, looked in by Moore. And they bring him down, but not until he crosses midfield. So they come to the line for first down and 10. Here's Jameis. To the left side, he's got Njoku. The Browns going to use the last of their timeouts now. They'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go until halftime. A good spot here, second and a yard. Now Winston, gonna look deep, looking for Moore. That is gonna be called in, he's got it. Elijah Moore, touchdown Browns. So they take the shot downfield and it is caught in the end zone for a touchdown. What a big play that is, Greg.
Absolutely, Mike. And the key to a play like this is when the ball travels this far in the air, they teach you, don't look back, look up, because that's where the ball will be. And in this case, he was able to secure it and come away with a big touchdown.
Dustin Hopkins now to add the extra point. The kick is good. And the Browns are on the board. It's 10-7. They didn't leave much time on the clock to put together a drive here at the end of the first half. And the kickoff's coming their way. This one is fielded in the end zone, but he will not bring it out. It's a touchback, and this drive will begin at the 30-yard line. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. He'll work his way forward for about 3 yards. That's Greg Newsome in to make the stop. So we've reached halftime, and the visiting Ravens are in front. As we'll get you down to Orlando now, that's where the coach is, Jonathan Coachman, and our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Mike, thanks very much, and welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. This one's been as good as advertised. Just a field goal separating these two teams. This is a very level first half, and I'd expect to see more of the same after the break.
Okay, Coach, thanks a bunch. We'll see which team's adjustment's going to pay dividends here. Likely going to play a big role in who wins this one. Three points, all that separates these two sides as half number two kicks off. Pierre Strong on the return. Good return here. Brings it up to the 33-yard line. The Browns offense ready to get going again. They'll have it first in this third quarter. This one has been tight so far. A field goal separating the two sides as this drive kicks off with first and 10. To throw, Winston in trouble, and he's going to be taken down.
If your quarterback is going to make a habit, Mike, of operating outside the numbers or the outer third of the field, you better neutralize the EMOL. So what EMOL stands for is the end man on the line. It could be a defensive end, a linebacker, or any walked up perimeter player who is responsible for setting the edge. You have to get them accounted for, because if not, you better keep your quarterback in the pocket or else you're going to suffer a lot of sacks.
Now Chubb. And he'll only manage to pick up 3 yards. And that leads to third down. Winston. Open man, and that's Tillman. He got a lot of what he needed, but just not enough. The mark is a couple yards shy of the first down, and here comes fourth down.
Well, it goes without saying. You want to play wide receiver in the NFL, Mike. How well can you change directions? How fast can you get your body from one direction to another? And when you can cut like this guy, I'm not sure how you guard him.
The Ravens offense getting ready for their opening possession of this second half. They lead by a field goal as they go to work with a first and 10. It's the tight end Likely in motion. On first and 10, Jackson. And he can't hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. What a good job defensively to meet him just as the ball was arriving. And it'll be second down.
A rare miss for a quarterback that we've seen really come out on fire throughout this entire contest. I mean, his completion percentage, Mike, is well above league average. And frankly, it's really the biggest reason why they find themselves out in front.
Can he get away? No! He's taken down behind the line. Good job by the defense with a negative play.
This play here, Mike, is just all about the get off of the defensive line. Watch how fast they go when that ball is snapped. Nowhere for this running back except to go down for a loss.
Third and long. From the gun, Jackson. He finds his receiver. That's Bateman. And they're going to get this all the way up close to the 40-yard line.
This is clinic tape for any young wide receiver out there watching this guy run routes. He has the defender thinking everything is a go ball. Attack him vertically, and then when you get to your route depth, you stick that foot in the ground, you break in, balls on time, results in a nice first down pickup.
They'll come up first and 10 at the 40. Aguilar goes off in motion. And he's not going to get too far, tackled after a gain of just a yard. Here's second and 9. In motion comes Andrews. They will not get this one off. It'll be a delay of game. Bateman is the motion man. Second down, Jackson. That's over the middle to the tight end, Andrews.
And this is where the versatility of the tight end position really starts coming into play. Not only do they have to line up with their hand on the ground, but they can occasionally split out in the slot. And man, they're too fast for linebackers, and a lot of times they're too big for defensive backs.
It's the tight end Likely in motion. It's a zone read, and Jackson's going to keep it. And he's not going to get the first down. Met and brought down in the backfield on third and short. They do not get it done.
The idea here for this offense is you're not really thinking necessarily touchdown. You're thinking first down. Let's get a fresh set of downs here and reset. But in this case, they suffer a loss, and it brings up fourth down.
On fourth down, the Ravens call on Jordan Stout to punt. On the return, it's Moore. And he's going to be brought down after a short return. And that's where his team will get possession of the football. Now it's the Browns' turn as they get set to take over again on offense. They'll do so with first and 10. They'll start on the ground with Chubb. And they're going to mark him down up past the 35.
The ability to be effective on first down, Mike, it just makes everything else easier. In the event you do have to face a third down the road, they're usually a lot more manageable situations, a lot easier to convert.
So, from the 36, it is first and 10. They're going to bring him down, but there is a penalty marker on the field. Winston looking to throw. There's a short throw caught by Njoku. Hook him up on a second down and 8. Here's a handoff to Chubb. And he will not be able to get free, picking up only a yard. Now, it's third down. To throw is Winston. That's caught. It's the tight end Njoku.
I think this is one of those plays that when the ball carrier watches this back in the film room tomorrow, he's going to be a little frustrated with himself. If he could just have made that one guy miss, he picks up the first down. Instead, he gets brought down short of the sticks, and now they got a fourth down decision to make.
The Ravens offense about ready to take over once more. They'll begin with first and 10. In motion comes Andrews. From the shotgun, here's Jackson. To the tight end, Likely. And they'll get about four here as he is taken down.
It's not the big play they were hoping for, but first down efficiency, staying ahead of the chains, is what every offense is trying to find, and it brings up a manageable second down.
Here's second and six. Bateman is the motion man. On play action, here's Jackson. This one complete to Bateman. And he won't make it back to the line of scrimmage. Going to lose a yard as he steps out of bounds.
Similar to a tight end, the slot receiver is often considered the safety blanket. He makes all the difficult catches, tends to be a little bit more around the line of scrimmage, and so far today, he's certainly lived up to that reputation.
And he's got it to Flowers for the connection. And he will have this at midfield, forced out of bounds there. They get the conversion on third down. It was a gain of 27.
I really like the rhythm that this offense has found. I mean, that third down, that wasn't a layup by any means, but they made it look easy. Everybody was exactly where they needed to be. The quarterback did a nice job working through his progression, saying, okay, I understand this is zone defense. I understand where the limitations of the coverage are. I'm going to get to that spot on the field as fast as I can, deliver the ball, pick up the first down. When you put plays like this on tape, it sends a message to every defender across the league. When you play this offense and this guy has the ball, you better bring it when you come to contact him, because if not, you're going to be on the wrong end of it.
It's the tight end Likely in motion. So, points at a premium. Defensive battle so far as we are through three. Back with more after the break. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. An enviable spot to operate from. Here's second and inches. Bateman is the motion man. Again, it's Jackson. That ball loosely, and it is out, and the defense has it. Well, he certainly turned that into something on the move downfield. Looked like he was gaining yards, but then loses control, and the defense comes up with a turnover.
Early on, Mike, it looked like it was going to be a really good play by the quarterback, turning to his legs, getting some pretty good yardage with his feet, but then he failed to not only protect himself but mostly protect the ball. Defense is able to put a hit on them, jar the ball loose, and now they'll take over after the big takeaway.
Set to go now on first and 10. They'll stick to the ground. And he'll get two on this one before being taken down. Second down and eight. A second down throw for Jameis. To the left side, into the hands of Moore. Here we go. Third and a yard. They'll keep it on the ground. He's going to have a Browns first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert on third and one.
Really just the same approach that an offense would take on a quarterback sneak, Mike. You don't necessarily have to spring them for a huge gain. Can you buy just enough space up front to pick up 1 yard? That's exactly what they did. Pick up the first down.
On first down, it's Winston. He'll get that complete to the tight end, Njoku. That's a nice pickup on a first down throw. It's a gain of 8. Here's second and two. They'll run here. And no place to go, no place to hide. He's taken down behind the line.
How often do we see linebackers be so fast trying to track down the ball carrier that they end up actually overrunning the play and allowing the running back to cut back? But not this guy. Does a great job staying in phase, stretching this ball out sideways, and he brings him down for a loss.
Quick throw, taken in. And he's going to have the first down taken down after a short pickup of five, but it will keep the drive going.
Critical third down conversion there, Mike. Now brings up a fresh set of downs. You find yourself here trailing in the fourth quarter. They got to go down and score, and they got to score fast.
They'll run. It'll be stacked up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play.
Well, this has been the story of the entire game, Mike, is just how well this defense has played, particularly against the run. There has been nowhere to operate for this offense, and it continued here on this last play.
We'll try again. It's second and 10. Out of the gun, it's Winston. Who else? Another catch for his favorite target. And the tackle is going to be made down at the 40-yard line.
And this is a tricky part of the game for any defense. You find yourself protecting a late lead, and the age-old question is, do you remain aggressive? Do you try to just keep the ball from being thrown over your head and make everything be tackled and played in front of you? That's what every defensive coordinator struggles with, so they can't get too soft here as they try to hold on to this lead here late.
Here's a second and six. From the gun, Winston. A throw, right side, taken by Njoku.
And this is the blueprint, Mike. The ability to sustain and maintain possession and methodically move the ball down the field in the process. The defense has had no answers up until this point. And now the next step is, can they come away with six? Because anything less than that, after this long drive, would be a bit of a letdown.
Quick throw taken in by Judy. And no chance to turn and go. That one good for just a couple. Right back to Judy. He's got it again. And he'll be stopped short of the first down. He's able to look it in and get forward for a pickup of about eight.
Receiver just finds himself in a really nice groove. And there's these weird times in the game, Mike, where it just seems like every ball comes your way. Every play they call, you're wide open. And you just find yourself in one of those grooves that athletes talk about. So they got to continue to ride the hot hand, because right now on that field, there's no mistaking who it is.
And the Browns are going to have a first and goal coming up as they find a way to convert on third and one.
That's a really important pickup there on that last completion. Not only does it set up first and goal, but allows everybody in the huddle to just take a deep breath. We're no longer in this frantic offensive possession. Let's get our best play. Let's make sure everyone understands what to do, because we know we need to finish this off with six if we can. And now being first and goal is going to go a long way in allowing that to be possible.
He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
This is one of those situations that plays directly into the hands of the defense, because think, Mike, they know this offense has to be one-dimensional. This has to be a pass. So what do? They bring in extra defensive backs. They clog up the back end. And at the end of the day, there's just nowhere for the offense to go with the ball.
On second down, Winston now sets up a screen for Chubb. Stop at the six, and that sets up third and goal.
Just a little slow developing on that screen play there. It was pretty obvious to the entire defense exactly what was going on. Nobody was thinking pass. Nobody was getting back into their drops, and just nowhere for that back to go.
It is third and goal. They'll drop to throw. That is incomplete. And here we go. They're down to what could be their final play. It's fourth down.
They desperately needed that one, Mike. Down here late, they've only got a few remaining snaps to go, and it puts all of the pressure of the game now on fourth down. Let's see what play call they have in a gotta-have-it situation. And right now, this quarterback needs to make his best throw in the biggest moment of the game. And this is where it pays to have a kicker you can trust, Mike. I mean, this is as big a spot as there is. Fourth quarter, what does he do? He comes out and he delivers to tie up this game.
Tie game. Still time to break that tie, though, as you see. Maybe run a two-minute offense. And the kick's in the air. And it'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. Lamar Jackson and the Ravens headed back out again. And he has been masterful so far leading this offense, keeping the mistakes to a minimum, on point with his passes. Generally, one step ahead of the defense all game long. They'll come up for first and 10. To throw is Jackson. There's a short one caught by Andrews. And he'll be taken down up at the 40-yard line.
I think it's clear, Mike. I think they have their sights set on winning this game in regulation. I don't think overtime is even in the picture. They're trying to be aggressive, continue to move this ball down. Can they find a way to pull this game off here late in the fourth quarter?
He finds Likely, his tight end. They'll come up now for second down. From the gun, Jackson. And this one's going to be a loss of yardage. He's marked out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
Really well done here by the defense, Mike, executing this zone defense. And they've got to be able to pattern read. You're not just going to drop back to a spot and just play like a robot. Based on what the receivers do off the line, the defenders have different rules of where their zones move to. Well, they had that one dialed in right from the jump, and they were able to stop that play really before it got started.
On third down, Jackson. He'll try to run for it. Now the Ravens use their first timeout, and they'll get a chance to talk things over after picking up that first down. Now Jackson. Oh, he can't get rid of it, and he's taken down.
You can tell the quarterback has built a lot of confidence in his ability to make plays today with his feet. The defense has had a hard time keeping him in check, and this time, much better job in pursuit. Even though he was able to get outside the pocket, they were able to chase him down and bring him down for a sack.
He'll find Aguilar, complete. And he'll be hauled down at about the 35-yard line. final minute, still two timeouts remaining as we get to first and 10. Here's Henry. And he surges forward for a gain of about 5. Now we'll get a timeout, Cleveland. That's their second. Clock stops with 33 seconds remaining. It is second down and 5. Henry. And a nice tackle in the open field limits the gain to only 1. Now a timeout here by Baltimore. That's going to be their second. And the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds to go. The Dog Pound, as usual, doing their part. This is third down. Now, Henry. And this defense holds its ground. They stop him for no gain. And fourth down's coming up. And we are set for a great finish. Timeout, 2 seconds remaining in the game. So out comes a guy who's been here before. Big spot for Justin Tucker. This to win the game. The Browns going to use the last of their timeouts now. So out comes a guy who's been here before. Big spot for Justin Tucker. This one he's gotta have. This kick is good. And it's celebration time. A walk-off victory on the game's final play. So it is a win here for the visitors, the Ravens. They get themselves into field goal range for one final shot. Kicker delivers. They avoid overtime and come away with a 3-point victory. And that'll do it for my partner, Greg Olson. For our entire team, I'm Mike Tirico. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. So long, everybody.